Minister.
Hiya.
Hi,
Mr.
Gloria.
Abbott.
Hi.
I would like...
Let's take a look back at the year that was. The year of stopping the boats. The year of scrapping the carbon tax. The year of being a bit creepy.
So, it's been 12 months since Liberal Party leader Tony Abbott took the top job. So, how exactly has he done?
You would probably give the Abbott government and Prime Minister Abbott himself a pass mark.
Which is fine if you're happy for the leader of Australia being a C-grade student.
And it seems like Australia isn't, with 54% of Australians disapproving with the current leadership.
Not happy, Jan!
Kicking off his leadership, Mr. Abbott announced his cabinet and came under fire for the lack of women.
Yes. Where are the ladies, by the way? There are some ladies in this delegation.
There are, yes.
Where are they?
Naming himself Minister for Women.
What the housewives of Australia need to understand as they do the ironing.
And for the first time since 1931, not announcing a science minister.
Now, I think that the climate change science is far from settled.
Once all the formality of swearing in the cabinet was done, it was time to start following through on some election promises and...
Stop the boats!
So, we were introduced to the jingoistic, overly militarised and highly secretive Operation Sovereign Borders.
I mean, Jesus knew that there was a place for everything, and it is not necessarily everyone's place to come to Australia.
And it actually worked, with the boats ferrying starved families seeking a better life stopping almost immediately. And by immediately, I mean the government stopped reporting on them and then instead had weekly secretive briefings. And then they stopped doing those. So,
next, Mr. Abbott headed to Afghanistan and declared a bittersweet end to Australia's deployment in the country. It was a lot better than previous visits. Well, the next shit to happen was the introduction of the carbon tax repeal legislation, which would lead Australia to become the first country in the world to abolish a price on carbon.
Really? Come Christmas, the government's approval rating had fallen below Labor's, and they would continue to do so until, well, they haven't stopped.
Douche chill.
Fast forwarding now to March, and Abbott shows his British heritage and reintroduces knights and dames to Australia, presumably because it reminds him of a simpler time.
Who are you?
We are the knights who say... Nee.
No, not nee. The knights who say nee.
The same!
Hockey delivered the government's first budget. It was a moment that was going to be one of Tony Abbott's biggest tests. And he failed. The PM's election promises of...
No cuts to education, no cuts to health, no change to pensions, no change to the GST, and no cuts to the ABC or SBS.
We're broken pretty much straight away, with cuts to literally all those things. So far, it doesn't look as if the budget is working out so well, with the cost of living rising, as well as unemployment reaching a 12-year high at 6.4%.
And that leads us to where we are today, with 2 years until the next election and a whole world of possibilities. Like, what will Tony Abbott do next?